Mitchell Point is one of the last segments to reconnect all 73 miles of the original historic Columbia River Highway. And we like to say that we left some of the most challenging pieces to last.
Mitchell Point's it's a big exposure of several layers of basalt rock. Some of the zones in those layers are really fractured up.
Rockfall's been a big part of this project from the beginning.
You know, we've seen rockfall at Mitchell Point for years.
We have lots of technical experts out here looking at Mitchell Point and how to safely proceed with blasting.
We are positioned several geologists down on the road level between the portals in a safe zone between the two blasts so we could see where rock was coming down.
Not a lot of rocks are making it to highway, but it seems like about half a dozen each blast, and with the volume of traffic on the highway and that these rocks are coming from 200 feet up or more, be very dangerous to anybody down below.
During rock blasting, we are using rolling slowdowns for everyone's safety, including people traveling on I-84.
Knowing that we're getting rock fall into the road and they're, you know, fist-sized to gravel-sized rock, that's enough to puncture someone's tire, to kick up into a windshield. But just catching people by surprise with a hazard in the road on the interstate or on a highway is dangerous.
So the rolling slowdown makes sure that nobody is on the road when those rocks come down.
You can find information and schedule for rolling slowdowns on our project website and on tripcheck.com. You can also sign up for email updates so you know when to expect rolling slowdowns and can plan ahead.
And we really take it seriously. It's a really cool project too. I mean, everyone wants to see it come off well and come together.
We appreciate everyone's patience. We know rolling slowdowns can be an inconvenience, but it's all for everyone's safety and to help us reconnect this last piece of the historic Columbia River Highway State Trail.